Meantime, an important glass ceiling was broken today when Kamala Harris became the country's first female vice president. Delegate Eleanor Holmes Norton is a longtime civil rights activist. She represents the District of Columbia in the Congress, and she joins us now. Eleanor Holmes Norton, welcome back to the NewsHour. Thank you so much for being here. Tell us what you took away from today.
From today, Judy, you saw the effect of arrests after January 6th insurrection and tightened security that followed it. Sitting where I was as a member of Congress, you couldn't see that. But if you represent the district as I do, you saw it every day. I live on Capitol Hill. The mayor had to get a police escort to get me through to the Capitol. That's just how tight it was. I certainly hope this will relax. And Judy, I think it will, because I think this security has had a deterrent effect. We all around the country and the states, we saw very little in the way of demonstrations. They were very puny. I think that had we had the kind of force at the Capitol when Trump inspired an insurrection, that we would not have even seen that near as bad as it was. And I certainly think that the deterrent effect was felt throughout the country today.
No doubt that would have made a difference on January the 6th. But it was, as you say, under very different circumstances. Delegate Eleanor Holmes Norton, let me ask you this. What gives you confidence that because today was quiet, that will continue to be that way?
Well, one thing that gives me confidence is that Trump is no longer in power. So you're not going to see people, particularly when you see what kind of a job the FBI is doing. The FBI is rounding up hundreds of people, and now on social media, they're able to do it. They're rounding them up, they are arresting them, and they are charging them. So people have to decide, is this really worth it? And I think we're seeing we saw the beginnings of that today with the puny demonstrations, even in the states. And when I think the effect of the FBI arrests is having its own effect on individuals. So I'm not among those who said just wait. And I saw some of that in your earlier news report that it could get much worse. Well, I'll give you an example. There were to be demonstrations here on Monday. Why didn't they occur?
Mm-hmm.
I believe that there had already begun to have an effect, the tightened security that we are now finally seeing here in the Capitol.
Well, I know everyone would certainly like to think that times are going to stay safe for as long as we can imagine into the future. But I also want to ask you about the historic first today, Delegate Eleanor Holmes Norton, and that is Kamala Harris not only being the first woman, but being the first Black, the first Asian to become vice president. You've been involved. You go back to the 1960s. You've been very active in thinking about these things. What did that mean to you today?
Well, I think we've seen perhaps, I think, as many as six vice presidents become president. This president is the oldest president ever. He could decide not to go for another term, but I think she is really in line to become president of the United States, and what a first that would mean, the first woman and the first Black.
The first, after President Obama, the first Black woman.
Black woman. First Black woman.
How much?
Yes.
Let me ask you about the what Joe Biden is trying to do. He has a fairly ambitious agenda in terms of what he wants to see spent to fight, to help people in this pandemic economy. Do you see among Republicans you talk to a willingness to work with him on this?
Well, he has one advantage, and that is that he has worked with Republicans his entire life. The man's been in public life and in the Congress for more than 30 years. So he starts out with an advantage that no Democratic president has had. I think that there will be some chastened Republicans. I was pleased to see so many of them show up and speak at the inauguration. And I think that it's important to also recognize this is a moderate Democrat. That means, it seems to me, particularly with his experience in the Senate itself, that he is in a position to find rapport across the aisle.
What do you think, just in the very little bit of time, few seconds we have left, what do you think he should be focusing on first? And do you favor the impeachment trial taking up days to come early in his term?
I don't favor the impeachment trial. I think the first 100 days must be focused on what it should be the focus of this presidency. Now, I'm not going to say D.C. statehood, but I'm pleased that he is for D.C. statehood and that we have the House, the Senate, and the presidency, which puts us in a good stead to get it. But his agenda is laid out for him, Judy. He's got to focus on the virus. He's got to then look at the economy. That's written for him. And I think he's been plain spoken that that's what he's going to do.
Delegate Eleanor Holmes Norton, representing the District of Columbia, thank you so much. Very good to have you with us.
My pleasure.